G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today I want to talk about hats and cosmetics and unusuals and gibbouses and free-to-plays and premium players and stuff like that. Because people ask me, you know, Mr. Paladin, do you change the way you play depending on who you're playing against? And that's quite obvious, yes. I mean, I've said it before, you do whatever the enemy team is going to let you get away with, and if you can figure out or even manipulate how they're going to act to you, that's even better. Let's see if I can take this health pack away from that demo man who was pushing up. Get rid of this sticky as well. So yeah, I often go into servers, I change my name, I don't wear my unusuals, so I might be able to manipulate them into thinking I'm not as good a spy as what I appear to be. You know, see what I can get away with. I'm always mindful of who I'm disguised as. Like, if I'm disguised as a guy with no cosmetics, I'm gonna act like I have no cosmetics. If I see a guy who's wearing a bunch of unusuals, I'm gonna give him credit that he's probably been playing the game for a while. Until they give me reason to believe otherwise. I mean, I've seen some players with unusuals that probably either just bought them, or they were just trading. See this soldier, for example. He looks like he knows what he's doing. He's moving like an experienced soldier would move, and I did not expect that spy there. So I've got to give him credit. I've got to play like he's had a bit of experience in this game, like he's got several hundred hours under his belt. And I've got to bear in mind that if he's around, he's probably either going to check me no matter what disguise I have on, or stop me from escaping. And I'm going to try and buy some time for our spy here, just pretending to be a friendly pyro. Oh! I wasn't watching my own back. Oh, nice knife. So let's have a look at our team while I'm dead. This spy's got a default Lutron J. I can't see his cosmetics. That demo man has some achievement items. So he's got a few hours. Now, you see the difference between those two pyros. One was a gibbous, and one looked like he had a bit of hours. And we've got a burning sniper. Burning anger, I think. Gotta watch out for that teleporter, it's getting camped. Okay, that demo man's all limed up. Oh, I love having my ringer ready that fast. So I'm gonna have to pay attention to that demo man over that. You see how I basically ignored that engineer? Because the engineer probably doesn't know I'm a spy. He probably can't aim. Look, see, he buys the fact that I'm using a scout disguise and he's actually checking his own spy. I missed my backstab on him though. Looks like they've picked up a medic now, and the medic's wearing a few cosmetics. I bear in mind to change what my disguise is holding, but there's an engineer building above me. It's that same engineer. So, you know, he's probably played Engie before. But he hasn't played this map much because he's building in a pretty bad spot. And he falls for a stab. There we go. So, you know, you can figure out what you can get away with based on how much experience you think they've had. They were all distracted at the cart. That was nice. Okay, I'm on a scout disguise. No equipment. Go to the medic. He's wearing some good stuff. Bumper spy. Try and find a spy. He didn't go that direction. Scout saw him. Whoa, I got hit hard. Oh, health's gone. I'll wait on it. Oh, scout needs it more than me. I'll let him have it. I'll go to the other one. We got a bit of back and forth in the chat. Okay, I hear a sentry gun shooting at something and they're up in the locker room. And I hear an IM charge, so that medic is good to go. Look like a sniper, see if I can get in behind him. I can't get behind the medic, but I did get his pocket. Random crit. I'm dead. Yep, that's me. Thanks for pointing me out. Jeez. Looking around on our team, we've got a couple of new players. Hey, our new engineer at least is building in a nice spot, but unfortunately they haven't capped here yet, so I would prefer if that sentry gun was outside, if we could get it there, but you know, he's doing what he can. You just can't expect everybody to have the same amount of experience as you, and I think that's where some of the bad part of the game comes from, where people are always expecting everyone to have the same experiences that they have had. You know, just because you've played several hundred hours doesn't mean that everyone else knows what they're doing. Whoop, missed that stab. Mistimed it just a little, but the pyro didn't see where I went. Sorry, AFK medic. Can't let you stay there. Ooh, I got in behind the pyro. Ooh, thank you. My appreciation. Now, don't underestimate the players who have no cosmetics. I mean, there could be players who have played first-person shooters in a lot of different games. I mean, it's not rocket science unless you're a soldier to play Team Fortress 2. It just takes a little bit of experience knowing the maps and such. I found the same thing with playing Overwatch recently, you know? I've played a lot of first-person shooters, so I was able to slide into Overwatch pretty easy. Whoop, I didn't expect this guy to go this way. Because it's actually a long way. Can I have a go at this medic too? No, let's back off. Thanking my teammates there. Oh, can't have that sentry going up, but this medic's in my face. I'm lucky that wasn't a crit. They always crit. Darn medics. Now, I'm not seeing any action, but I'm seeing in the kill feed, there's even a taunt kill. They're pushed up all the way. So what have we got here? We've got an enemy. An experienced medic, the good soldier. And they're all up at our spawn. So let's see if we can disrupt this. Couldn't get on the medic. The soldier backed up. I'm not going to go to this near spawn. They'll just block me in there. I'm going to go up top. See if I can get up here without getting shot at. Oh good, we've got an unusual wearing pyro now. He might be able to reflect on the soldier. He got one reflect. He got him. Good man, good man. Let's see if we can pick up this other pyro and clear out our spawn. Nice to know who you can depend on your team. Who's got your back? Because you can't do everything yourself. You never can. It's Team Fortress, for crying out loud. Okay, I'm a scout who's not wearing any cosmetics, so being derpy at the front line probably could be expected in the heat of battle. Okay, I'm as a pyro, so I'm going to pretend that I've had to back off from my teammates, hide behind this corner, see what's coming. I was disguised as that pyro, he should not have believed that. He should have checked me down. So now I've got in my head that pyro in particular is probably still new, probably doesn't have enough hours, can't spot a spy. Is that him again? Well, see, that engineer, even though he was new, is now starting to check me down. It's good that he's learning. It's all a learning experience. That's the fun of it. Now, they can see me if they come out of spawn. He called for medic. Oh my goodness. He did see me and he called for medic. Okay, I see a sniper over there. Ow, 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 ow. 1 HP. I got away. That was fortunate. I'll have to go for that sniper, but first I gotta take care of my health. Okay, so that sniper, he's not wearing any cosmetics. He's staying pretty much fully scoped in, so he's probably new to the class. understanding the experience level of your enemy will let you decide how you should proceed. Now, that pyro probably saw me. A quick look back, yes, he saw that I was changing disguise. So he went to the nearest health pack, didn't find me. Okay, everything looks good there. Spy picked someone off, though, unfortunately. Not my job to take care of that. Okay, here's a sniper. Remember, he's staying hard-scoped. It's probably new. Easy stab. Oh, I missed my stab on the medic. How unfortunate. Oh, wells. Gotta get my health back before I go back in. The scout disguise has been working, but I'm gonna switch it up to medic as I go back towards him, but then I see this in the locker room. And he comes down for me and does the medic chase. Yes, he does. Can I get him on a corner? No, a pyro is on the scene. Dang it, can't clean up that medic. Was that a spy? No, but that was a spy. Spy is demo man. Well, bumping a few as I come out here. I'm just going to have to eat it. I'm on a medic, but I've been using the medic disguise a bit. I think I'm going to switch it up to a pyro. Pyro's using the back burner. Oh, they're attacking. Not on my watch. This is my cart. There are many like it, but this one's mine. Okay, that was good work by the soldier. He's ambushing there, but I threw him off. Come up, check the locker room again. Coming up as a sniper, because a sniper might be up here. And we pick up the demo man, who's wearing limes. Looks like they've got a few pyros, because every time I go pyro, I'm getting a different disguise. But I've got the same disguise as this pyro. Oh, he should he should kill me here. I should be dead. He's just playing with me. Can I get him? Oh, he didn't come far enough, but I pick off the sniper, and I get away. He used up all his ammo on the air blast, being derpy. Oh my goodness. I eat it. I eat the damage to get into their back line. Since I'm back here, I go medic and see if I can pick someone up. Gotta watch it because I can see me coming out of spawn. Did this guy see me? He's not moving. Ring is ready again. Well, we got a teleporter. I would have laughed if they had gone through that teleporter right then and got me. They removed the sapper. I am on a red tape. I'm going to have to do a video soon about when and why to use red tape as well. It's not as bad as people think anymore. Oh, okay. Now we know enough about the sniper to know he's probably not going to see this. Oh, he moved! Oh, got it. You know, plan that. That went exactly according to plan. So yeah, thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. And don't be too worried about your cosmetics, especially as a spy. I mean, you're often under a disguise anyway. Your cosmetics don't really matter. They get you a little bit of bonus points with the community, but, you know, just enjoy what you wear. But don't put too much stock into what people wear, only that if somebody does have a coordinated or an expensive outfit, they've probably got a few hours in the game. Bonus footage. Here are some other kills that I just happened to get while recording this episode. Enjoy.
più dry farfalloni amoroso. Notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle turbando al riposo. Ma ci sento a doncino d'amore.